So, good afternoon again. So, we are going to do another bit of working on the landy 4x4. So, let's see if everything is working. Let me check my microphone. Yes, that seems to be working fine. I did again make a few small changes, so I hope everything will keep working. Please let me know if there are issues with sound or something like that, but I think everything should be working fine today. So what we are going to do, we probably will be streaming for around 1.5 hour, and then I want to watch the Formula One qualification. So we will see how far we are going to come. The very next step is going to be the build of the rear axle. And let me close it quickly. So we are going to get that to work, so let's switch over to the camera and let's turn on the let me fix that very quickly. So I did forget to save something, I think, again. Let me see. So we do want to have camera 5, I think. Let's see. Yes, that's better. So it should be loading now the presentation again. Yes, there we go. And let's start the presentation. So we are going to assemble the rear axle. I already got all parts that we are requiring for this ready here. I do have everything around, so let's get started. Let's see how far we are going to be within this 1.5 hour or so. Sorry. And let's get it done. So what we need is print 31 and 32. So I have those here. And we are going to need to do some post-processing. So we do need to remove the supports from these parts. So let's put these to the side. And let's see if we can get them out as easy as the other parts. Looks like we can. So let's grab a plier. We'll get there. So that's one side. That one went a bit easier. So that's one. Also, I did switch chairs because I did hurt my back a bit last stream. So it might be a bit loud sometimes, unfortunately. But otherwise, I won't be able to do this for very long with my other chair. So I'm sorry for that. I do need to get a new chair. There we go. And these aren't pusha slicer supports. So these supports are actually built in the part itself, as designed by 3Dsets. But they are still pretty easy to remove. I would say a bit harder as pusha printer or pusha slicer supports, but they are still pretty easy to get out. There we go. And we need another two. So, ow. That was nearly into my eye. So you do need to be careful. Hi Pokon, how are you doing today? Ah, nice. So yeah, need to work on Saturday again. Doing fine, a bit of weekend. It isn't that nice weather as last week, but you can do stuff inside, right? Okay, so we did that. And then we need to get it assembled. So let's see. The black one is filamentum extra fill PLA. And I also do have some red parts, and those are generic plastics.nl PLA. So everything of this is PLA, and that actually is recommended by 3Dsets. So we need this one. And this, we need this, differential shaft. This one, we have the housing, and we need to remove the brim from here. There we go. Make sure it's clean. There you go. Okay, and we need a bearing. And M310. This should fit in here, yes, perfectly. So we need to get this side like there, goes a bearing in here. This goes in here like that. An M310, I put it here. A bit of filament in the way there. Oh, it's already gone. Okay, have a nice work day, Broken. Thank you. let's see how we can get this together without damaging it. Not sure. So can I hold it like this? Yes. So I need to be careful not to damaging it. So I think this should be fine for now. So there needs to go a bearing in there as well. And then this goes here. And we need to clean this part by the looks of it. There we go. And that fits together okay enough. So let's see. So we need to get but this does rotate, so that's good. Not sure what's the difference between the rear differential parts. And the front differential gear part. That's a very good question. So this is plate 33, so let me see if I can find in Prusa slicer the difference between the two. If it wants to start. And we want plate 33, I think it was, or 31, let's see, yes it's this, to look pretty much the same. So I have no clue what's different between those two. They do look the same, so I just assume it is okay. Let me punch the holes. Okay. And what we do need to do is get the one of these. They need a bearing for that. Or like so. Interesting enough, this doesn't really fit into here. And none of these, so that's the same at least. And we need to get the housing. And you would think it's this one. So I'm just going to insert the bearing into here. Like that. Then we need the drive shaft. And that needs to go in like this. And this goes on to here, and we need an M310 again to make it fit. So let me clean this up a bit more. There we go. And let's try to get this screw in here. There we go, perfect. Okay. And we need a bearing on this side as well. So let's get a bearing. And this spins really nicely. So we need to apply grease on the on here. So let's go like that. And then it goes in like this. And we need M26. And we have those here. I did check to make sure I do have enough of those M26s. And I actually did order two of those bags. So that is a good thing. So let me also switch again to the presentation on the computer. If it wants to do that. It's a bit slow today. I do want to check if it's the right way around. Yes, it is. Is it? Is it the right way around? No, it isn't. Okay. So let's remove it again. It needs to go like that. And I noticed this larger screw hole wasn't fitting, so that was actually the problem. And I also noticed it's really bright again. Let me lower. Is it better? Let me do it like this. Okay, and then let's get a small hex key and get everything properly closed off. Did it move again? Yes, it did. and then two more, and then I think we are going to do the other side of this. It will not be as nice to put together as this side, because we can put it on its side. So we will need to do a bit of improvising for that side, but that should work. Okay, there we go. And what I do want to use now is try to get this one a bit more tight. Does need to go a bit more, but we are getting there. There is my small can't find there. There we go. And what I do want to check if this is still going well. It is. There's a tiny bit. Of resistance in, so I do want to add a bit more grease into there. Okay. Still there, but should be fine. Okay, let's continue to the next page. So basically we want to do the same here, and we need to get it's not this one. Do they are different? Yes. It's this side, and then we need to get this part. And a gear. And again, we need to get this into here. It won't fit. So they are different. Okay, so you found out they are different. Huh. By luck that we have the right one for the other side, I guess. get this into here. There we go. Need a bearing for this side here. There we go. And we need a bearing for this side. And then this just goes in like that. Moves perfectly. And we just add a bit more. Just a bit, well, not like that. But okay, I guess more is better in this case. And then it goes in like this. Let me check to see if I did anything wrong here. No, I don't think so. So we can screw this together. That. Just slightly. It wasn't going into the printed hole correctly, so we needed to move it slightly. And just to before we continue, let me make sure everything turns around as expected, and it looks like it is doing that. So that's great. And the last one, and then we just need to tighten them around.
it's not true. Around tools,
I guess. And two more to go. There we go. So let me grab a quick drink. And I see it's on the wrong step again there. So it suggests or more tells us to use threadlock here. Unfortunately, I don't have any. So I will add that later. Actually, let me make sure that's true. Let me quickly have a look. It's not damaged anything here. I do actually have a bit of threadlock. It's not that much left. So let's use it. Let's clean my desk here. I need a few more. Ooh. There we go. And let's grab one of these, insert it here. And then we need this part that goes on there like that. Okay, and we do need two more screws for there. And the other side as well. And all of this moves, so that makes it a bit hard to get it in. That's one side. And the other side. I do notice this is going a bit out crooked, but it looks like that's by design. Nice. It does move really smoothly, so that's good. So let's see what we also need to do here. We need a part with, we need this part. And that goes in. And that's just one. Okay. And we need an M316 there. M320, M316. There we go, and that's it for this part. So let's continue to the next step. So here again, we are going to do the front axle. So we just did the back axle. I'm sorry for my chair again. So we did it in just over 45 minutes. So with a bit of luck, we can finish it. And that's what we want, I guess. Because I do want to leave at 3:30. So this looks like a bit more complex, but we will see and try to get it done. And otherwise, we will be doing it tomorrow, maybe this evening, but I don't think so. I might do a stream after the Formula One, But that depends a bit on how much alcohol I had. Because I don't think it's a great idea to do this with a lot of alcohol in my body. So let's grab all parts. We don't need that. We do need two of these. We need this. And we need to remove the brim again. Hopefully that plastic didn't go into my drink. Because that won't be a great addition. Let me quickly clean up this part. There we go. And then we need an M310. We need a Cartesian joint for lift diff. Yes. These two parts. That part. We don't need these yet. And we need two bearings again. And we need to clean up this part. Okay, and then we insert the bearing into there and into there, and we just insert this into here and this into here. And then it fits again like that, or it should fit like that. Bit more cord left over there. There we go. Then this goes onto there again, and we have an M310, and I forgot to clean it. I always lose my tools. There it is. There we go. And basically the steps here are the same as the back axle, so it's pretty much the same, just a new axle. I'm wondering if I did break a bit of this part, but it should be fine. Otherwise I will just reprint that later on. We did all of that, so we then add and it's like that. We need not that part yet, or do we? No, we need this part. We need this part, sorry. And we need one of these. And we need two bearings. And a front. And there goes in M310 again. There we go. There goes in a bearing on this side here. And one on this side here. This goes into there, like this. And then we need to screw it in there, and we need to add grease on there. Like so. And this goes on like this. And we need to bench off M. Like this. Get the right tool again. And then let's get all of them nice and fast. Okay, and the last one, I believe, for this side. Okay. And let's make sure everything turns, and it does. Perfect. Okay, so let's see up to the next step. And we are just over an hour of streaming, so going to the right way. So basically we need to do the other side, yes. So we need this, we need yes, what other part do we need? This part? Yes. Two more bearings and a that we need to insert this into here like so, and we need a M310. To fit all of this together. And this goes into here like that. That moves, we add a bit of grease onto that. And it goes onto that like this. And there we add more screws. I do need to switch bits again. Let's make sure everything turns around as expected. That one does, and that one as well. Perfect. So let's continue screwing in this. Someone is calling me. One moment. Someone trying to get my attention that I don't want to right now. Okay. Sorry for that.
that's not the wrong spot. We need to have this one.
Damn it. Because I'm not using magnetic screws, my magnetic screwdriver won't help with this job. There we go. And then we need to insert these all properly. There we go. Okay. So let's go to the second part of this page. We need these two. We need these. And we need two of these. And we need M3 tens twice. Okay, we need to clean this part from the brim. And the same with this one. There we go. And there's a bit left. And let's quickly clean it with a
good enough. Okay. So we do need to punch this. Okay, and then this one goes over here with an M310, yes. And we need to do the same at the other side. So this go onto there. Doesn't really matter if they are the same or not, I guess. But they are pretty much. Interesting. There is XR written on there, so I assume these are the right ones. Okay, and then we need to insert more of these blocks. So basically they go in like this again, and we grab a smaller bit. Interesting. There we go. I was already going to say what's happening there. And then we need to insert two here as well. then I need to grab a new bag for these and to six them. Because it was empty. So that means we did use hundreds of those screws already in the build. Which is interesting. There are a lot of them in there. And I believe, I did look it up, we are going to use nearly all of them that in this are in this bag as well. I think we are only leaving out four or something like that. There we go, and then we do need to turn it around, get this in again. And get four more screws in. And after that, we are done again with this step. And I might look into what the next step is to see if we can finish that. And otherwise, we will just go and stop the stream and we will continue the next time. And when the next time will be is not sure yet, like I said. I might do one tonight, but that depends fully on how I am feeling after my dinner. And otherwise, maybe tomorrow afternoon or evening, or otherwise, we are going to continue on Monday evening. There we go. And let's make sure everything is turning all right, and it is perfect. So let's see what's the next step. So we need to add a few more parts. So we need to hold it like this. We need a bearing over there and a bearing over there. Then we need this part. That goes like this in M310. Where did it go to? Yeah. Sorry for my noisy chair again. Oh wait, we do need to add a M3 nut into there. Interesting how we are going to do that. So that goes there. Okay. Let's try this again. Oh, here. Okay. Let me get it out. Let me clean this quickly. Let's try it again. And let me grab a few more entry tents. And I did put it in the wrong way around. Damn it. Okay. The nut dropped out again, of course. Okay, so it goes in like this. Let's have another try. Okay, Let's check it to be sure. Yes, everything is right now. And I do think this will be part of the steering. So I think we probably should not over tighten this. And there's our nut again and out again. So we do want to have this part to be movable. So let's do the same in the other side. So we want to remove again that bearing, directly insert it into there. Do the same in the other side. Need to clean up that first. Just need to do a bit more cleanup. Yes, there we go. And then it goes in like this. Grab a nut. Let's do this side first. Let's there we go. M310. Insert the nut in the other side. There we go. Get another screw. Perfect. And let's see how, yeah, we are basically done, but I do want to finish this step now. So let's see. We get this part, and that goes like this. And we need an M325. And that goes through there. Then through there. And there goes this. That goes there, and an M3 lock nut goes on there, so let's grab one. I do know I need the other one for the other side, so I'll grab that. And we need an M3-16 for that side. So and we also need a lock nut on there. Let me grab. Something is wrong here. Yes. Damn it. Don't have time for this now, Paul, to make mistakes like this. So we first do it like that, then it goes into there. Then a lock nut goes on there. Good. And then we do need to screw down the other side as well. Okay, let's make sure everything still moves. It does, perfect. And what we then also need to do, where's the next step? Now. Uh-oh. Yes, we did it the wrong way around. Okay, I did it the wrong way around. So what I am going to do is I'm going to stop this string. And I will fix this, and then next stream we will put this, continue on working on this. As I do want to watch Formula 1, and that will start very soon. So I want to thank you all for watching, and we will see. I'm not sure when we will continue, but that might be tonight, and otherwise some other day later this week. So thanks all for watching, and hopefully see you next time. Bye now.